England expects. Prince Harry leads rugby fans gathering for the World Cup final in Japan as millions tune in across the world to see Owen Farrell's heroes take on South Africa for their second title. Prince Harry is leading hundreds of thousands of rugby fans in Japan gathering for the World Cup final as Eddie Jones's team take on South Africa in a bid to win their second world title. The Duke of Sussex has already delivered several messages of support, and Meghan Markle will be watching at home with baby Archie while Zara Tindall and her ex-rugby player husband are also in Japan to watch the game. Millions of fans are gathering in pubs across England for the game that will kick off at 9 a.m. today. The Duke of Sussex is representing the royal family and cheering on England against South Africa at the International Stadium in Yokohama. The Queen sent the team her very best wishes for a memorable and successful match, saying the performances during the tournament have delighted supporters and inspired many people throughout the country. Prince Harry, who hand-delivered the message, also sent his own good luck message, accompanied by a photo of Archie in a red rose jersey. Harry is patron of the Rugby Football Union, RFU. The Duchess of Sussex, who has stayed at home, revealed their 5-month-old son Archie will wear a mini England jersey when they watch the final on TV. Thousands of England and South Africa fans began filling the streets and bars of Yokohama 7 hours before the Rugby World Cup final was due to kick off today. One primary school teacher admitted she left her job to be there for the fixture. Teacher Ann Wheeler, 27, said, "No school is going to give a teacher 6 weeks off to watch rugby, but when will I get the chance to come out to Japan and do this again?" The teacher appeared on Good Morning Britain yesterday, where her and her girlfriend, Genevieve Moody, gave a rendition of Swing Low Sweet Chariot. Newlyweds Rosie and Ken Marshall will cheer on rival teams after spending their honeymoon traveling around Japan to follow their sides. England supporter Jamie took a different view, saying, "Well, England play the better rugby, South Africa play boring, military style, vicious rugby. We played the aesthetically pleasing run-around rugby, so we deserve to win and we will." The other hot topics of conversation were tickets and travel, how much paid, around £2,000 seemingly the going rate, and what last-minute arrangements were made to get here. "One minute I was planning a watch the rugby breakfast at my local club in London, and the next time going straight from the airport and watching New Zealand v Wales in an Irish bar last night. I didn't even go to the hotel on the way," said England fan Matt, clad in an immaculate Crusader outfit, complete with inflatable shield. "I came in via Osaka this morning, I only booked the flight on Thursday," said James. "I'm spending more on 3 days here than on a 2-week summer holiday, but I just couldn't miss it." Mr. Marshall, 37, is originally from Johannesburg and lives with his English bride, 31, in Birmingham. They will don their respective team shirts at home this morning after returning to the UK last week. Mr. Marshall said, "They are the best England team I've ever seen. But I'll always be a South Africa supporter and back the Boks in any match, especially a final. Rosie and I will be happy for the other whatever the result, even if bragging rights will be decided for the next 4 years." Prime Minister Boris Johnson joined in with the final fever, declaring, "The whole country is behind you, through every kick, ruck, line-out and maul. Come on England. Bring the World Cup home." The Duke of Sussex warmed up for today's World Cup final at a training session for would-be Japanese Paralympians, and discovered that one or two of them were rooting for England opponents. "Who are you guys supporting tonight?" he asked a group of wheelchair rugby players at Tokyo's new Para Arena for disabled athletes. Back came a chorus of England before Domosij Kaba, and he piped up, "South Africa." "I'll have a word later," joked Prince Harry. "You might not get selected for the Paralympics." Domosij, 32, explained that South Africa had been Japan's last opponents in this tournament, hence his support for the Springboks, before adding, "This year you became a father. We are so happy." At which point the whole group gave the Duke a round of applause. Dressed in a casual shirt, blue chinos and trainers, Harry was shown around by powerlifter Yuri Yamamoto, 36, who hopes to compete at next summer's Tokyo Paralympics. having been at the 2012 London Paralympics as part of the Japanese support team, she told Harry that she hopes that Tokyo 2020 can be a worthy successor. "London set the bar very high," she said. The Duke explained how 2012 had transformed public interest in disabled sport - "it's just got bigger and bigger," he said, and he wished Tokyo well for next year. Harry also met a group of schoolchildren, including Shio Sudo, 12, who said that he was very handsome and pointed at his wedding ring. "I'm married," Harry said proudly, holding up his left hand for all to cheers and to hoots of laughter. Eddie Jones's side are favorites to take the Webb Ellis Trophy for the first time since 2003. It's the first final since 2007 that hasn't included New Zealand. The streets leading to the international stadium are filling up with rugby fans, and many of them are wearing All Blacks jerseys. Traveling New Zealanders would have expected to see their team in the final, given the expectations back home and the fact that the All Blacks won rugby's biggest prize back-to-back in 2011 and 15. Instead, they had to make do with the bronze medal after the All Blacks beat Wales 40-17 in the third-place playoff on Friday. Eddie Jones's men are favourites and unchanged after that stunning victory over the All Blacks in the semi-final, and while Rassie Erasmus Springboks are in Yokohama thanks to their narrow win against Wales. This showdown is a rematch of the 2007 final, which saw the Springboks triumph 15-6 in Paris, and with the Red Rose out for revenge.